Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. In today's video, we're going to have a look at why you might want to upgrade from the free version to the paid version of DaVinci Resolve, the studio version. And there's one tool that might want to convince you that upgrading is a good thing, and that is the Magic Mask. And in this video, I will show you how you can use Magic Mask to do color grading, to do some pretty cool effects pretty fast using the Magic Mask. If you want to, for instance, make me black and white using the Magic Mask, and it takes no time to do so. We can change colors of things, put text in behind you, all kinds of cool stuff, and I'll show you the basic of that in this video. So without further ado, let's just jump into DaVinci Resolve. Okay, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve, and let's just get started by showing you these things you can do with the Magic Mask. So let's just jump right into the color page, and we're going to start this clip right here. We are going to select the Magic Mask, and there's two options in the Magic Mask. It is the object or the person. I find that the object works very good for persons, actually better than the person mask, so I always use the object mask. So it's just going to select this and make sure that the qualifier is selected here. And then it's just a matter of drawing on the subject. Let's just do that. See if it does a good job. And if we go over here, we can toggle on the overlay. And it did a pretty good job. I think maybe we want to add in this piece of hair here. And if there's something we don't want, we are simply just going to click on the minus here, and I can zoom in. And there's like parts I don't want. Look like that, I don't want that either. And here we can go in and take out some parts as well. Something like that. So we can refine this. And of course, if we go here and change the quality of our mask to better, like that, it's going to be a way better mask. I think this is a pretty decent mask. So if we go here and we click the forward and backwards analyzing, it's just going to analyze our clip pretty fast. And let's have a look at what we are going to get out of this little effect in 1 second. It is very fast. To do the tracking, we're going to take off the mask, and we're also going to toggle off the qualifier. So let's say we want to make this person here black and white. We can do that just by taking out the saturation, like so. And then we could go in and bump up the contrast and play around with the temperature a little bit, something like that. So now we have this clip here of this girl in black and white. For instance, this is pretty good if we want to do some kind of a mood for this film. We could also invert the selection, so the background is going to be black and white. And we do that just by going in here to the mask and then just toggle on this button right here, because that is just going to invert the mask. So there we have girl in color sitting in black and white. Maybe that is the effect we are going for. So we're going to go to this clip here with this guy. And then what I want to do here is I want to make his shirt a different color. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into the object mask again, going into the plus, and make sure that the qualifier is on. And it is. And then I'm just going to draw on the shirt here. So let's see, something like that. And now we have a lot of things we don't really want. I'm going to change this into better. And then I'll go into the minus, and I'm going to take out the parts I don't want. I think there's a part here I don't want. Something about the pants, and we can just zoom in a bit. I also want to take this part out. So overall, this should be a pretty good track. So we're going to track forward and backwards yet again, and see if that's going to stick. Well, more or less, that is a great track. So what I can do now, I can go into the color wheels, and I can go into, for instance, the gamma, and I can drag down the color here to, let's say, a little more greenish. I can go into the gain. I can drag that towards green as well. And in the lift, I can go that and press that towards green. And then I can go into the saturation and take out some of the saturation. So we have now changed the color of the shirt from blue to green. All done pretty fast and pretty easy using the Magic Mask. So for the next one, I want to show you how to do text behind a person. And we do this a little different, but let's say we have this clip right here in the edit page, and I'm going to push Alt and drag and put that on, let's say, put that on the third video track. I'm going to right click and I'm just going to change the color just to make things easier. And I want to take some kind of a text. So let's go into my titles and let's see, I have something from Motion VFX I think could be fun. Let's take some of the, from the film pack. I did do a review about this pack, so you can check that up right up here in the top corner. It is a great pack. There will also be a link down in the description below if you are interested in the pack. So I'm going to put the text right here. I'm just going to highlight the top clip, push D for deselect, and I'll just go in here and I'm just going to change the text pretty fast to something else. Let's just change that to dance, like that. And everything else is going to be just fine. I'm going to take the top layer again. I'm going to push D to select it. And I'll jump into the color page. And I'm going to do the exact same thing on this clip here. Taking the Magic Mask, going to the plus, make it better. And we're just going to draw on the girl here. So hopefully we are going to get everything along here. So let's see. Maybe that's good enough. We're going to go forward and backward, and we can then see how we did. Lovely. So with everything tracked, we will go out here and we're going to push the right mouse button and we're going to add an alpha out. And then we're just going to connect the output of the mask into the input of the alpha out. Like so, we'll go back to the edit page. Now we should have her in front of the text dancing. So that is how we can do these three effects using the Magic Mask. So this is just one of the tools that makes investing in DaVinci Resolve Studio a great option. Anyway, I do hope you found this little video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share with your friends if you think it would help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.